God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do.
In the beginning, God made everything. God simply spoke and the world came to be. He sent a flood and made everything new. He parted the sea and let his people walk through.
It's game time! Where in the world? We're going to give you 7 clues. See if you can guess which country we are describing. Clue number 1. This country is located on the continent of Africa. One of the world's longest rivers flows through this country. Clue number 3, this country is home to one of the 7 wonders of the ancient world. Number 4, this country is mostly made up of hot deserts. Clue number 5, many events in the Old Testament take place in or around this country. Clue number 6, the kings in this country were known as pharaohs. And our final clue number 7, long ago people made homes in this country from bricks made out of mud. Do you know which country we are describing? Well, here comes the answer. Let me guess. You didn't pick Canada. You picked Egypt. If you did, good job. All of these facts described Egypt, a key location in today's Bible story.
The other team is up by 16 points and it feels like we're not gonna make it. But remember, we trained for this. This is why we did those drills. All those drills, all those practices, it's for this moment. This is where we dig deep. We stick with the plan. We're in the third quarter of the semifinals, guys. We're so close. That means that we win this game and we move on to the championship game. We have come a long way and I know you can do this. We've come this far to put it all on the line. We're not turning around now. We can't turn around here. We're in it to win it. So, we're gonna show them what we got. Are you with me? Nope, one more time. Are you with me? Let's go, Dunkin' Donuts. All right, back in the game. Here we go. Ah, hey, I'm Coach Duncan, and it's really good to see you. I'm really glad you came out to support us. This team could really use another win. We're so close. If they beat this team, they'll make it to the final game. And if they win that game, they're the champions. Oh, so good. You know, sometimes good things do come out of bad situations. That reminds me of today's Bible story. Well, my team needs me, so remember, stick with God's plan and you'll always win.
Last week's story, where God changed Jacob's name to Israel? Jacob returned home and made peace with his brother Esau. Jacob got married and had 12 sons. Yes, 12. One of his sons was named Joseph. Let's look at where we were on our giant timeline. Today's Bible story is called Joseph Sent to Egypt. I wonder why Joseph went to Egypt. As you listen to the story, keep in mind our big picture question, which is, what can stop God's plan? Do you remember the answer? Shout it out. What can stop God's plan? Nothing can stop God's perfect plan.
Jacob had 12 sons, but his favorite son was Joseph. Jacob gave Joseph a colorful robe. The other brothers saw that their father loved Joseph the most, and they hated Joseph. One day, Joseph shared with his brothers a dream he had. He dreamed that he and his brothers were putting together bundles of grain. Suddenly, Joseph's grain stood up, and the others bowed down to his. Then Joseph had another dream. Joseph saw the sun, the moon, and 11 stars bowing to him. This dream meant all of Joseph's family, including his mom and dad, would one day bow down to Joseph. Joseph's brothers were jealous. One day, Jacob sent Joseph to check on his brothers, who were tending to the family's sheep. When the brothers saw him coming, they decided to kill him. Joseph's oldest brother convinced the others to throw him into a pit instead. The brothers saw a caravan of people heading to Egypt, and they sold Joseph to the travelers as a servant. In Egypt, the travelers sold Joseph to an official named Potiphar. The Lord was with Joseph and made him successful at everything he did. But Potiphar's wife accused Joseph of doing something he didn't do. Potiphar believed his wife, and Joseph went to jail. Even in jail, God was with Joseph and blessed him. The jail warden put Joseph in charge of the other prisoners. Joseph cared for two of Pharaoh's top officials. Joseph told them what their dreams meant. Joseph said that one day, the cupbearer would serve Pharaoh again. Joseph asked the cupbearer to remember him and to tell Pharaoh that he did not deserve to be in jail. Pharaoh had two dreams. Pharaoh saw 7 fat cows eaten by 7 skinny cows, and 7 fat heads of grain eaten by 7 thin heads. No one knew what these dreams meant. That's when the cupbearer remembered Joseph. God told Joseph what Pharaoh's dreams meant, and Joseph explained the dreams to Pharaoh. "God is warning you about what is about to happen," said Joseph. The dreams represent 7 years of lots of food, followed by 7 years with no food. You should pick someone to save food during the good years to use during the bad years. Pharaoh listened and realized that God was with Joseph. So Pharaoh made Joseph second in command in all of Egypt. No one was more important than Joseph, except for Pharaoh himself. Joseph stored away food during the good years. And during the famine, people came from all nations to buy grain from Joseph. God sent Joseph to Egypt and blessed him so that he rose to a position of great power. God used Joseph to save Joseph's family and many others from death by starvation. Jesus gave up his position of great power to be the Savior of the world.
Can you imagine how Joseph felt when his brothers threw him in a pit and then sold him to travelers going to Egypt? Joseph was probably glad to just be alive, but he probably missed his father. In Egypt, Joseph worked for Potiphar, an Egyptian leader. God was with Joseph and made him successful, so Potiphar promoted Joseph to be his personal assistant. And just when things were looking up, Potiphar's wife accused Joseph of doing something he didn't do. So Potiphar put Joseph in jail. Not only was Joseph far from home, he was locked up in a prison for 2 years. How did Joseph get out of jail? Pharaoh needed someone to interpret his dreams. And God told Joseph what Pharaoh's dreams meant, and Pharaoh made Joseph a leader of Egypt. God sent Joseph to Egypt and blessed him so that he rose to a position of great power. And God used Joseph's suffering for good. He used Joseph to help Joseph's family and many others. In a similar way, Jesus left his position in heaven to come to earth and be the savior of the world. It's review time. True or false? Number one, Jacob's favorite son was Benjamin. False, Joseph. Number two, Joseph's brothers loved Joseph. False, they hated him. Number three, Joseph had a dream about grain bowing down. True. Number four, Joseph's dreams meant Joseph would rule over his family. True. Genesis 37 verses 8 to 10. Number five, Joseph's brothers threw him into a deep pond. False, an empty pit. Genesis 37 verses 23 to 24. Number six, Joseph was sold to people traveling to Bethlehem. False. Egypt. Genesis 37 verse 28. Number seven, Joseph was imprisoned with the king's cupbearer and baker. True. Number eight, Pharaoh had a dream about seven healthy crocodiles. False, they were cows. Number nine, Pharaoh made Joseph second in command in all of Egypt. True. Number 10, Joseph stored up gold in Egypt. Food. Joseph was a young man when his brothers sent him away to Egypt. He spent 2 years in jail. Everything seemed to be going wrong, but God was with Joseph, and Pharaoh put Joseph in a position of power so he could store up food for the famine. God used Joseph's suffering for good.
Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Nigel used to live in England. When his parents told him they were moving to the US, he was sad.
I don't want to move.
He had lots of friends, and his basketball team was having a winning season. Everyone knew he'd be crowned the most valuable player if he stayed. He was sure his life would be terrible in another country.
I do not want to move.
Do you think Nigel will be all right?
Number one, have any of you ever moved to a new place? Number two, what did you like least about the move? Number three, what did you like most? When we hear about Joseph and know the whole story, it's easy to see that God used Joseph's suffering for good. Do you think Joseph knew what God was up to when he was sitting in jail? Maybe not. Sometimes we have to trust God's plan, even when we do not understand what he is doing. God used Joseph's suffering for good, and he can use hard things in our lives for good too. Remember that God is in control over everything. He is good, and he has a plan. What can stop God's plan? Nothing can stop God's perfect plan. God's promise to Abraham extended to Abraham's future generations. In this verse, God promised to be with Isaac. God was with Isaac, with Jacob, and with Joseph. Do you remember our memory verse for this unit? If you have it memorized, then close your eyes and say it with me. Let's read Genesis 26, verse 24 together. I am the God of Abraham, your father. Fear not, for I am with you and will bless you and multiply your offspring for my servant Abraham's sake. Genesis 26, verse 24.
Hey kids, read Revelation chapter 13, verses 1 to 3, and then draw or paint what comes to mind.
Send your finished artwork to the church office either by messaging us on Facebook at LMMC or by emailing them to office@aemmc.ca. I'm excited to see what you come up with, and we'll even showcase some of your masterpieces during church and during online Sunday school. This message will self-destruct in 5 seconds.
Let's pray together before we go. Lord God, thank you for your word. Thank you for your stories like Joseph, so we can know you better. You are working in our lives, and even when we do not realize it, you help us trust you for everything. Help us remember Jesus, who suffered the most to give us the greatest good, salvation from sin. We love you. Amen. See you next week. Bye.
Me say